Good morning, friends. This is Dr. Manishan, Department of English, Ramjapal College, Chhapra. Today, I would like to take the topic from the syllabus of BA Part 1, Honors English, Paper 1. Starting with the Unit 1, the sub-theme is Major Trends in English Literature. This unit will be divided into certain subdivisions. And two questions will be there in the examination. Each question will carry 15 marks. So this unit is not only important because of marks, but also it is a base of English literature. As far as we know, that when there is a chronology of many of anything, so to a better understanding, historians divided it according to the directions, to the ways, to the philosophical outlook. Certain things could be modified in historical perspectives. So it is with also English literature. To get a better understanding of it, historians divided it into major periods. And these periods, as far as the major direction of the historicity of English literature goes, it is divided on the date line, but date line also took the directions of trends. So there is not a significant way in which a literature is produced during a particular date. Many types of literature being produced in a particular date, in many genres, in many philosophical outlooks, in the treatment of subject, in characterization, in rhyming schemes, in syntactical patterns. So the thing is not that that in this period there is some strict nature of writing or reading. There are certain molds also in this. But in going with the line of historical reading of English literature, as a major historians of English literature has propounded it, it has been divided into certain periods along with deadlines and the major trends being focused in that time period. If an author is writing not on that line in that particular period, it will be dealt in a significant way apart from the major writers. I am not saying that he or she is a minor writer of that age, but to give the prominence of the trend in that period, historians shift this writer in some other section of that particular period. So let's start with the division of English literature. As far as we know that when something took birth, it will be added into ages, develops, get polluted, refined, certainly will be conquered by death also. But that thing is far away. The birth of English literature could be considered with the birth of considered along with the birth of England as a country.